From volleyball crazed Omaha, Nebraska comes a special night in the history of the sport. Tonight, the Omaha Supernovas host the Atlanta Vibe for the first match in Professional Volleyball Federation history. Welcome to the CHI Health Center alongside Emily Eamon. I'm Jake Herman. Emily, the wait is finally over. A concept years in the making becomes a reality tonight. Just how big is this night and this league for the context of women's volleyball in America?
Tonight shows how far the sport of volleyball has come in the United States. To have these players playing on their home soil in a real professional league where they can make a real livable wage, and to do that in front of friends and family, it's incredible for the players and for the fans, but also it shows those younger players coming up through the game what's possible beyond the college level.
Well, there are seven teams participating in the inaugural season. Let's show you who and where these teams are. Tonight, we're in Omaha, the home of the Supernovas. They're taking on the Atlanta Vibe. Orlando, Columbus, Grand Rapids, Las Vegas, and San Diego, the seven cities playing in year number one. Each team will play 12 home games, 12 away games, and the season culminates in the middle of May, where a champion will be crowned and win a $1 million bonus prize. As for who those championship teams will be, a coaches poll was taken before the season asking who their preseason favorites were. And the top two teams, the ones you're seeing here tonight, Omaha receiving the most votes, Atlanta receiving the second most.
Look, it's so exciting to have two of the top teams in the entire league competing on the opening night of Pro Volleyball Federation. These top two teams are absolutely stacked, too. The Supernovas have so much experience. They have three Olympians on their roster with outside Betty De La Cruz, setter Natalia Valentine Anderson, and middle blocker Tori Dixon. Atlanta, on the other hand, they're relying on so much youth. This team only has a combined 22 years of professional experience, but it's going to be a battle up front. We have stars on both sides that are sure to make a splash and turn some heads.
They are stars everywhere you look, and we'll meet some of those star players when we unveil the starting lineups and get you all set for first serve. Get a moment. It's a packed house here in Omaha as a star-spangled banner concludes. And we get ready to meet some of the stars of the Pro Volleyball Federation. The all-league team was announced just a couple of days ago. And Emily, from top to bottom, what an amazing list of players that were included in that.
And some names that people might recognize if you're familiar with the college game, but some international stars on that list as well that I think people are really going to notice early on in this matchup. You see stars like Leah Edmond, Morgan Hens tonight for the Atlanta Vibe. And if you go down, Bethania De La Cruz, she is a stud from the Dominican Republic for the Supernovas. It is a packed league, and there's a lot of players that are going to stand out.
Two former Texas Longhorn middles represented on that list as well. De La Cruz and Edmond, both unanimous selections to the All-League team, and we'll get to see some of their talents on display tonight. In your opinion, what makes Leah Edmond so hard to stop?
Leah Edmond really has the potential to be one of the best outsides in the entire world. She is such a power attacker. She's spent the last 3 years as a professional getting better and better. You know, people might remember her from her time with the University of Kentucky, two-time SEC Player of the Year, four-time All-American, just stacked up accolades left and right. But what makes her so good is she's such a big-time scorer. She's a great all-around volleyball player, a really solid passer, and really watch out for her in the back row because she's used just as often, and she'll score just as easily.
Last year's Athletes Unlimited champion spent some time in the broadcast booth over the last couple of collegiate seasons. She's taking her professional career to Atlanta, joining the Vibe for this season. And then at the pin for the Supernovas, Betty De La Cruz, over 22 years now of professional experience, another unanimous all-league selection.
Betty De La Cruz is one of the best outsides in the entire world. She's had 22 years of professional experience, which, for perspective, is more than all of Atlanta's entire team combined. Betty De La Cruz is a power attacker. She hits with so much range, and teams really have to watch out for her from the service line because she's got a nasty topspin serve.
Not only has she represented the Dominican Republic in the Olympics twice, but she's been named the league MVP in four different countries. Will be a force to be reckoned with here tonight. Well, the Supernovas, they named their team after bright stars and explosive energy, and their starting lineup is full of star power.
Yeah, this entire Supernovas team is full of star power and a lot of players that are going to turn some heads, so it's no wonder that these head coaches voted the Supernovas a potential to win the league.
Tori Dixon in the middle. Her accomplished career included a trip to the Olympics. She lives just 5 hours from here and has been a real leader for this Supernovas core group.
And I'm really excited to watch Tori Dixon back in action, especially in the United States. We saw her have a stint with Athletes Unlimited, but so fun to watch her on the court and potentially dominate the Supernovas team.
The Supernovas, coached by Shelton Collier, are much like their head coach, a very experienced bunch with two very dynamic setters captaining their offense.
Yeah, they have a dynamic offense in general. They have two setters that are very experienced at their level. You have Natalia Valentin Anderson, who is an Olympian with the Puerto Rican national team. And then you have Sydney Hilly, who's likely to get that start. We'll see her on the court pretty early. Won a national championship with the University of Wisconsin-Madison. An incredible leader. Both of them really doing it in much different ways. But this offense is in really good hands.
It's an offense that thinks their strength will be just the variety of ways they can score. And with a starting lineup like that, Shelton Collier hopes they have a different leader offensively each and every night.
Yeah, Shelton Collier told us the other day that it's not just going to be, set Betty the ball and hope for the best. They really want to have balance in this offense. They want to get other hitters involved. And really getting those middles involved is going to be key.
One of those middles is Danielle Hart from Wisconsin, making her professional debut. So many Big Ten players for the Supernovas now back in Nebraska. Here's the Atlanta Vibe starting lineup. A much younger team for Coach Todd Dagenet, who has 15 years of experience at UCF. Who stands out from this group?
Yeah, it's Leah Edmond, the outside. She is a power attacker. We talked about her earlier. She was the 2023 Athletes Unlimited champion. She has so much potential, and I think what we're going to see from her tonight, and really as this league continues on, she's going to be a star.
The Vibe with plenty of Southern roots, six of their players coming from Southern states, eight of them went to colleges in the South, lots of Kentucky Wildcat influence with Allie Linehan, formerly Allie Stumbler, in the rotation as well.
Yeah, Allie Linehan is definitely a player to watch. She will play opposite of Leah Edmond for Atlanta. She's an incredible passer, a good leader for that team, and she can put a ball down.
This atmosphere is electric. Coach Shelton Collier called it both an epic opportunity and an epic responsibility. One of the volleyball capitals of the world gets to host such a big night in the history of this sport.
No better place to do it than in Omaha, Nebraska, a state that bleeds volleyball. They do volleyball better than anywhere in the entire world, so it's no secret that tonight's going to be epic.
Not a lot of empty seats to be had at the CHI Health Center as these two teams prepare to make history. The Supernovas and the Vibe get the show on the road here in the Professional Volleyball Federation. Alongside Emily Eamon, I'm Jake Herman with you here for the call as the Vibe travel to Omaha in front of over 10,000 fans. And we've heard that the parking lots are overfilled. Those empty seats could even be full by the time we get through this first set.
Well, it's no surprise. These fans in Nebraska love their volleyball. We knew from the second they announced this team here that every single match was going to be packed.
They play at one of the biggest volleyball venues in the country. The CHI Health Center has hosted numerous Final Fours, numerous Olympic qualifying and tournament matches. And it is electric here this evening. Sydney Hilly on serve and ready to make some history. The first swing for Linehan results in a point for the Vibe. And that's a big part of their game plan here on the road today. They want this capacity crowd to be as quiet as possible.
That was something that Leah had been told me before the game. She knew there's going to be a lot of fans in here, but they want to quiet them from the start and try to take control of this match really early.
Fanning serving white. Dug up by Shelley Fanning. Linehan off hands, covered nicely though by Leah Edmond. And it's 2-0 Atlanta.
Huge swing from Allie Linehan right out of the gates. Everyone in the gym knows where that ball is going to the outside. She did a great job hitting right around that block despite two big blockers in front of her.
It's a gym that Allie Linehan holds near and dear in her heart. Had that big performance in the national championship win over Texas here a couple of years ago. She had 26 kills in that match, helping the Wildcats bring home the hardware. The first Supernova serve belongs to De La Cruz. That one covered well by Hilly, playing the carom. And a same side attack, Grace Cleveland from the opposite pin.
One of the big differences from the college to professional game is really the length of rallies. We see crazy defensive plays left and right. Sometimes these rallies can be a lot longer because the defenders are just better in better positions. Definitely something to watch for tonight if you're only used to the college game.
So many of these players dominant throughout their college careers, even their professional careers, leading into this one as the block is tooled nicely for a Supernovas side out.
Brooke Nunneveller, number 5 in white for the Supernovas, really a utility player. Played a few years at libero at Oregon before switching to the outside and has been dominant ever since.
One of those standout American college players who has spent time overseas in Turkey. Big part of this league, bringing those talented players back here on home soil.
That was one of the biggest points of this league starting, was to bring those players back and have an actual ability to pay them a livable wage and keep them here, not just for a few weeks out of the year, but for an entire season from January to May, paying them a livable wage and being able to play in front of friends and family.
This is the start of a 24-game schedule as a big block. Karis Watson out of the middle.
Watson, one of the more experienced pieces to this Atlanta team. She's got 7 years of professional experience under her belt. She is a fantastic blocker, much better defensively. We'll see her get involved in the offense, but that's her thing, is on the defensive side.
Strong start for Atlanta. They lead 5-2 before that block gets tooled by Jess Shaven-Lantzman, the former Iowa State Cyclone.
And Shaban Landsman able to play on both pins there. You saw her on the right side get up. She's a player that is very good, really versatile. They can play her wherever they feel like they need her.
Right now she's back at the serving spot. Edmund tools the block off the antenna.
And Atlanta getting a little bit pin heavy to start. We're seeing a lot of balls go either outside or to that right side pin. You see Leah Edmund talking to her setter. Hey, let's either speed that up or spread it out.
See if Edmund gets another set here. Great up by Kendall White. Tip back over on two. Nunaviller forcing it back on one. That was Linehan. And a great cover there by Stringer. Leah Edmund ends up in the net, and the Supernovas win the longest rally in the brief history of Professional Volleyball Federation.
Yeah, long defensive battle on that one. That's what makes professional volleyball so fun. These players never give up. They are in spots because they know exactly where that ball is going to keep it up.
Serve misses long from Brooke Nunaviller. You'll see some players come in to substitute on serve, but not as many as the college game. Just 8 substitutions per match, so 2 more than international volleyball, but 7 less than NCAA rules. And presents challenges for both of these head coaches here on opening night as they try to manage those rotations. De La Cruz denied her first kill there by Linehan. And it's poked over wide. You'll notice the lack of line judges down there on the floor. Everything within 1 foot of the line called by Bolt 6 technology.
It's pretty cool tech, you know, similar to what we see in tennis, where it's automatic. They see where that ball is, whether it touches the line or not. Kind of takes that objectivity out of it just a little bit.
And a big cheer as Omaha's own Gina Mancuso-Prozoski comes in to serve. She was the first Nebraskan ever to be named the National Gatorade Player of the Year. It's been a real ambassador for the Supernovas in their startup process. Now, Coach Dagenet talking to our head referee tonight, our first referee, Devaney McLarty. I'm wondering if a challenge is coming here. And that last point has now been awarded to Atlanta.
Devaney McLarty saying that that ball was in, initially ruled out of bounds, but then that double check ruled in, as you can see from this Bolt 6 tech. You have the ball hitting that line, meaning it's in.
22 cameras around the court help Bolt 6 recreate each point. And is precisely accurate. A seamless review process that coaches can even initiate from their tablets down on the benches. De La Cruz threw a double block, answered by Fanning.
Good run from Tori Stringer, getting her middle of that ball in a difficult situation, about 5-6 feet off the net, but she trusts Shelly Fanning to continue that route and put the ball down.
How about this start? 9-4 Atlanta, timeout Shelton Collier and the Supernovas. Atlanta hitting 400 to start this match. They've come on the road in front of the biggest crowd that a lot of these players have played in front of in quite some time. and really taken that crowd out of the game in this opening set so far.
Yeah, this place absolutely packed, but that was something that Shelton Collier also talked to us about. Yes, these fans are invested in the team and are excited to be here. They also have to form a relationship with the team and get that investment from this high level of play because they might not be bought in quite yet.
Well, he said, we know the fans will be here, but are they here to help us win, or are they here to just watch great volleyball? We won't judge either way here on the Pro Volleyball Federation YouTube stream here tonight. Atlanta continues to pay extra attention to De La Cruz.
As they show, De La Cruz is one of the best outsides in the entire world, and Grace Cleveland did a phenomenal job there, getting her head lined up right on that ball to take away the shots.
Good start for Grace, the former Purdue Boilermaker. Side out, Danielle Hart, the former national champion at Wisconsin.
And that's a connection that has been shored up over years between Sydney Hilly and Danielle Hart, two players that have played together for so long as they both were at the University of Wisconsin. And that slide attack is Danielle Hart's bread and butter.
Hart's really enjoyed this rookie year experience, if you will, getting to learn from the wisdom of her teammates, citing Tori Dixon specifically, who comes into her spot in the front row now. Someone that's really mentored her throughout training camp. How about that angle? Over the block, but we wait to see if it was in, and it was out. Bolt six confirms point, Supernovas.
Grace Cleveland trying to go high hands on this ball, trying to catch a fingertip or two, but just hitting that ball a little bit long.
Cleveland able to paint the back line with a response.
That one looked a little bit more in control from Grace Cleveland, still swinging really high, but getting that snap down at the end to keep it in bounds.
Here's another look.
Watch right at the last second, that hand snaps down, putting some forward rotation on the ball, keeping that in. Now with Leah Edmond for Atlanta in the back row, watch for Tori Stringer to use her a little bit offensively from the back line.
The former Louisville standout setting here from the back. As the Supernova is able to scramble to put that one back, Cleveland dug out by Kendall White. Great dig the other way from Leah Edmond. Back row, Nunneviller looking for the campfire, but it was covered well by Morgan Hentz. Linehan with kill number three.
Atlanta turning defense into offense. This is what makes Morgan Hentz so good. There is not a spot on the court that she can't get to. This ball so difficult to defend right over the block. She's able to cover so much ground and get that ball high enough to transition.
So the service error gives the point back to the Supernovas. Trailing 12-6 here in the opening set. Here at the CHI Health Center, where Creighton University calls home. Quick hitter for Fanning, and the vibe clicking on all cylinders.
Atlanta looking really good in the beginning of the set, being a little bit too pin heavy. As the set's gone on, Stringer's doing a phenomenal job finding other hitters, and they're able to put it down.
You'll notice the fast pace to this match. A serve clock is part of the Professional Volleyball Federation rulebook, 15 seconds from the time the point ends until the time of the next serve. Linehan out of system. And a big swing that Tori Stringer was ready for. Cleveland into the pit.
Atlanta's doing a really good job in their transition. They're getting these balls up, but they're also getting them high enough to where they're able to get someone under it, whether it's Stringer or someone setting this ball out of system and giving them a good ball to take a swing on. That one not executed from the swing, but still a really good ball.
And we've seen the Stringer Linehan connection work well. That overpass goes right to Tori Dixon.
Now Omaha trying to get their middles involved, doing a really good job on that overpass, controlling the pace of the net and identifying that early on.
Many of the long points have gone Atlanta's way in this first set so far. Quick hitter there for Watson. Hilly able to keep it alive. Cut shot from Nunneviller, dug up by Morgan Hentz. Hilly, Red Linehan's push. But the point goes to Atlanta.
Atlanta really controlling the net on that play. On these high tight balls, that's exactly what you want to do. Get as big and those hands as over as you possibly can to shut down the hitters.
That's an imposing combination of Watson and Cleveland. The 7-year veteran and the rookie teaming up there. Beautiful back set, and Shaven Landsman terminates.
Great swing from Shaven Landsman on the right side, getting outside those blockers, identifying exactly where they were and getting on top of it really fast with this really quick set coming from Hilly.
Coach Collier called Shaven Landsman the biggest surprise on this roster as Hilly serves up an ace. Check that, Tori Dixon back to the service line. One of three Olympians on this Supernovas team who hasn't played in the States in quite some time. Her pro career has taken her throughout Europe and Asia, spending two seasons in Turkey before coming back to the States last fall. Hart read that one like a book. Edmund gets denied.
Danielle Hart stepping in and stepping up, reading that beautifully. A solo stuff. She knew exactly where Leah Edmund wanted to take that ball. Made a slight adjustment right at the end to drop her left hand to shut Edmund down.
A Virginia Beach native quickly becoming a fan favorite here in Omaha. Cleveland off high hands. De La Cruz there to pass it up. Betty gets blocked. That was Watson up at the net again.
Another big back row attack block. Watson stepping in this time, reading that back set so well, identifying where Betty De La Cruz wanted to take this ball. It's over her shoulder, so Karis Watson knew she had to step a little bit more inside.
As a younger team, Atlanta knows that they'll rely on Watson a lot, especially early in the campaign, as Hart continues to be the hot hand.
Danielle Hart gets it done on both sides of the ball. Not only is she a huge imposing block, but offensively she works so hard to get all the way off in transition and run her route with authority.
Part of the U.S. national team a year ago. The middle blocker with her second kill. So here's Natalia Valentin Anderson, the captain of Puerto Rico's national team. She's in on serve and will set from the back row here for Omaha. But that one falls in beautifully. A great change of pace.
Beautiful identification of where the defense was on the other side, seeing them pretty spread out and putting that ball right in the middle where they weren't.
So the former Clemson Tiger, Watson, serving De La Cruz. Side out quickly from Nunneviller.
Nunneviller is as springy as they come. She gets on top of that ball so fast, even if it's coming with a lot of speed. She speeds up her approach and speeds up that snap down to put the ball down so quick.
She's been a tone setter for the Supernovas in practice, even pushing the veterans at times to up the intensity. Omaha has cut this deficit, which was once 7, down to 1. And Coach Todd Dagenet wants to slow it down. Timeout Atlanta as Omaha makes their push. We've got a tight first set of Pro Volleyball Federation action. The Supernovas warming to the task here in the first set. They trailed early, but it picked up their energy in a run sparked by Hart and Nunneviller, two of the newest pros on the roster. Atlanta, from the timeout, goes right back to Grace Cleveland, who's leading their way in kills.
Cleveland putting that one down, but the Supernovas really making a comeback in this set. A lot of that's been from the service line, knocking Atlanta out of system, forcing them to use their outsides.
This is what both coaches told us we would see. Lots of 25-23, 26-24 sets. The teams ranked first and second in the preseason polls. Starting to get into a great rhythm out here now. That one's chased down by Tori Stringer. Chance here off the free ball, and De La Cruz ignites.
De La Cruz putting some pace behind that ball, identifying the seam so early on, and then using that high volleyball IQ, seeing that seam and taking a massive rip right through it against one of the best liberos in the entire league in Morgan Hens.
A couple of all-league preseason selections matched up on that play. And it was the veteran and the Olympian who got the best of that exchange. Edmund popped back up by Nunneviller. Chance for Cleveland. Sent back by Nia Reed. Blocked again. What a set for Grace Cleveland.
Grace Cleveland, the rookie, has come up huge in this set alone, getting a lot of balls on offense. Defensively, a few stuffs in there and really good touches to slow down the Supernovas' power.
One of the only true opposite hitters on this Atlanta roster has upped her level here early. That joust won by De La Cruz, who was looking for a call. Dixon has it popped up by Evan, and an acrobatic play by Linehan. Point Supernovas, though, thanks to De La Cruz.
And that'll get these fans pumped up. Those defensive battles, when you think that ball is down and all of a sudden someone comes running through to save it, this is why you have to stay in every rally and make sure that you're playing heads-up volleyball.
That's the veteran savvy of De La Cruz. The 36-year-old still dominating at the professional level. Linehan, who started this set with a couple of kills, pops that one back over. And the Vibe rebuild their lead, 19-17, four hits.
It feels like Atlanta's been in control this entire set so far. From the beginning, we saw them get up as many as 7 points, but even as Omaha started storming back, Atlanta's trying to shut it down as quick as possible.
Saving play there from Cleveland. Linehan off hands twice, and pass back over by Hilly. Kendall White there for a diving dig. De La Cruz heating up.
De La Cruz showing how much range she has as an attacker. We've seen her use that power and just barrel through blocks. She's also so good at these short little tip shots right outside the block, going for those fingertips to knock it out of bounds.
She's been mentoring the younger college players on this Supernovas team, taking them aside, providing some one-on-one coaching. That's the kind of personality and savvy she's brought to this locker room. And she's on serve, trying to tie this opening set. Quick hitter for Dixon, popped way up near the video board. Rolled back by Linehan. Shaben Landsman couldn't find the angle.
Shaben Landsman just hitting that one slightly out of bounds to the left, but Hilly putting her in a pretty good position to take a strong swing on that. And this Omaha offense has been so tough to stop because Hilly's been in charge and making it really deceptive. Atlanta doesn't know where to block.
Omaha in the net, and it is now a three-point Atlanta lead. Timeout, Supernovas trying not to let this first set get away. A back and forth opening set here in Omaha. The Supernovas hosting the Atlanta Vibe, who will get their chance to pack Gas South Arena on Wednesday, February 1st. Their home opener is against the San Diego Mojo. They're heading to Orlando on Friday, part of a busy opening week for Todd Dagenet's team. And they've got a tough test on their hands here, trying to close out this opening set in Omaha. The Vibe have led this set by as many as 7. See if Dixon can't find a run on serve. Shaben Landsman finds an opening.
Shaben Landsman off of a beautiful set from Tori Dixon, coming in a middle, using her hands. That's exactly what you want. A really strong, confident middle to step in and say, hey, I got this. I'll put up a really good ball for you.
We talked about Atlanta's busy week. It's a busy year as a whole. Over the next 16 weeks, 84 matches will be played in the Professional Volleyball Federation. Here's the slate coming up, including tomorrow night's matchup in Grand Rapids as the Rise host the Columbus Fury.
It's such an exciting time for the sport when we have now volleyball pretty much year-round. We go right from the college game now into professional volleyball with Pro Volleyball Federation. And for these two teams, you know, it's a grueling schedule, but so exciting as they play from now until mid-May, when they have the chance to earn $1 million in the Pro Volleyball Federation Championship.
But we're still getting used to it. For these rookies who are still getting used to professional careers, they say they made a deep run in the Final Four. That gives them only a couple of months before training camp starts. Even less than that if they made a deep run, like, say, number one overall pick Asia O'Neill did. She only took about a week to rest. She'll be on the floor tomorrow for Columbus.
And that's the reality of so many of these college players who want to play at the next level. Some of them, the day after the NCAA tournament ends, they're shipped off overseas to go play for a team out there. But so great that they now have the opportunity to do it on their home soil.
And we as fans have the opportunity to watch them as a timely setter dump. That's Tori Stringer, who you may know as Tori Dilfer from her All-American career at Louisville.
Such a smart time for Tori Stringer to throw in a dump. She hasn't been offensive all night. That caught the Supernovas on their heels.
The best setter dumps are often the ones that you least expect. Brooke Nunneviller gets the momentum right back.
Such a smart swing from Brooke Nunneviller, identifying she was one-on-one with only one block at her as Danielle Hart held that middle, so she knew she could rip that seam cross-court.
Supernova still yet to lead in this set. Edmund tools the block, and Atlanta 2 points away.
Now in the red zone of volleyball, this is when you want to see teams make as little errors as possible. Clean volleyball from point 20 on is so important, especially for these players right now in Omaha who's trying to catch up down too late.
We've seen very few errors as a whole in this set. A combined 3 service errors and only 3 attack errors on the stat sheet. And why not keep setting the former Oregon star?
Brooke Nunneviller coming up clutch. That's exactly what she does. In the big moments, she wants the ball. Now going to the back row, the Supernovas feel very confident setting her back there as well, saying she's actually their best back row attacker.
Yeah, Coach Collier didn't want to put a percentage or put a number on how many times they'll plan to set her from the back row. But she will be their go-to option from back there. Edmund causing trouble and bringing up a pair of set points. Leah Edmund and the Atlanta Vibe use an early run. They were up 13-7 earlier in this set. Now they have 2 chances to take the lead here on the road and maybe take this crowd out of it a little bit. Overcooked by Tori Stringer and a lifeline for Omaha.
And all of a sudden, Omaha feels like the door's cracked open just a little bit in this set, with a chance to come back with a good server back on the service line with Danielle Hart.
Hart's had a great set, including 3 kills and a block. Cleveland sent back on one by Dixon. Right back to Grace. popped over. Free ball for Linehan. Another Biller saves the set for now. Covering the block, Cleveland pushes too far. And in fitting fashion, the first set in league history will require extra points, and these fans are loving it.
This is exactly what you want in the league opener, a high-level, tight set with so much on the line.
Fanning on the slide, dug up by Hart. Hens able to cover a lot of ground, setting up a Cleveland swing, dug again by Danny Hart. Center dump, read well by Nunviller, and Shaben Landsman gets denied. And Atlanta gets a third chance to win the set.
Huge momentum shift for Atlanta to get a block in that moment, but really want to highlight the defense from the Supernovas and Danielle Hart stepping in as a middle attacker. So many digs in just that rally alone to keep the ball alive.
Edmund, no stranger to pressure moments on serve. Dixon has it dug out. Another impact play by Hentz. And the center dump from Leah Edmund wraps up the opening set. And if that's what we're in store for over the course of these next 4 months, sign us up. 26-24, Atlanta leads wire to wire in the opening set. Well, one set in the books and several to go in the newest indoor women's professional volleyball league here in the United States. Emily, I want to get your thoughts on that first set. Atlanta jumped out to the early lead, hung on to win it late, but what quality out there on the floor it just goes to show you what U.S. fans have maybe been missing all these years.
Yeah, it's been so exciting. I think the adjustment, if you've normally been watching the college games to professional, it's a lot quicker, it's a lot cleaner, and it's a lot more powerful. And you can see these stars really shining, especially from the defensive standpoint. We're seeing Morgan Hens cover so much of the court for Atlanta. Kendall White on the other side doing the exact same thing for Omaha. But really for Atlanta, it's been the outsides that have been carrying such a heavy load. Leah Edmond already racking up 6 kills in just the first set alone.
A lot to think about for Shelton Collier, the 41-season veteran at the collegiate level, over 1,100 wins over his time at Wingate, Georgia Tech, and Pittsburgh. He's also accompanied the U.S. national team to the Olympics. He said preparing for tonight's match was like a sprint and a marathon at the same time, as Tori Dixon starts the second set on the right foot. He said the season's a marathon, and you have to be ready for that, but tonight, and the adrenaline and the occasion that comes with it, is a sprint that you can't deny.
Yeah, well, I think Coach knows that there's going to be so many eyeballs on just this match that he feels like, not that they have to put on a show, but they have to have a little bit more figured out than they would if they had a little bit more time to prepare, or if it wasn't so much riding on this opening match.
That shot sails wide. So much of Coach Collier's approach to building this Omaha roster was player-led. He said him and his staff brought in a core group early on and sort of relied on them to say, will this player fit the culture we're trying to build?
He really relied on Sydney Hilly, Brooke Nunneveller, and Kendall White, and really used them to decipher who they wanted on their team as Omaha gets that ball. But there's a lot of people that they wanted to bring on that maybe that group thought they might not be the right fit for this team. And as we see now, the culture on that team is so great and they vibe so well together and are well connected.
A lot of big personalities, a lot of energy on that side of the net. Looking to raise their level here in set two. Linehan draws only tape. Dixon and Shaven Landsman were there in a 3-1 Omaha lead.
And Tori Dixon covering so much ground, getting all the way out to this ball, but staying inside, knowing that Linehan wants to take that cross-court shot.
So Dixon gets credit for the block, and that signature jump serve from De La Cruz comes back with authority. Kill number 6 for Linehan.
Not swing looking a little bit better for Allie Linehan, swinging a little bit higher and testing the edges of the court just a little bit better.
Shaven Landsman unable to get past Watson and Linehan. Todd Dagenet is the all-time winningest coach in the history of UCF. He's had several stints with the USA Olympic women's volleyball team, including a trip to Athens in 2004. He's built a team of younger players, a little bit less experience at the professional level, but certainly a team that's gelled together well and has plenty of depth. He said that depth will protect us in this league because, believe me, there are lots of people on this team that opponents have to account for.
And something he talked about was this team's ability to win. You know, he took players from winning programs, whether that was professionally or at the college level. He knows these players have such a hunger to win and have done it at really high levels.
He's got 3 pairs of college teammates on his roster who have been to the Final Four. As Nunneviller swing into the waiting arms of Edmond, Cleveland sends one towards Hilly. Hens covers ground, and a quick hitter for Watson works again.
Really smart decision from Tori Stringer on a quick bang-bang play. You get a quick free ball over, and if you know Karis Watson is going to work her butt off to get all the way off, you have to get her the ball in this situation, and she delivers.
Watson, who was in the coaching world a season ago, a volunteer assistant at Winthrop, has played in already 6 different countries over 7 professional seasons. The South Carolina native finding a new home here in Atlanta. So Shaven Landsman back to the serving spot. A 5-4 lead for Omaha. Remember, they did not lead at all during that first set, but forced it into extra points. service error. We're tied at five.
At this level in the game, every point is so important. There's so many sets at the professional level that go into extras because the level of competition is just so good. And that's exactly what you're going to see with Pro Volleyball Federation. Yes, teams are stacked, but it feels like every team is really stacked.
Yeah, stacked to the tune of 35 Olympians across all countries. 17 of those players in this league have been with the U.S. national team. It's not just on the court, too. It's in front of the benches. These coaches have over 2,500 combined victories between the seven teams coming in. Only one can earn the first victory in league history as Edmund misses wide. Again, those close calls near the lines called by Bolt 6 technology, the same technology used in Olympic Games and Olympic qualifiers.
And you might be asking, you know, why there aren't line judges here. It's because you have cameras right on there that call it automatically. So if that ball is within 1 foot, it'll automatically go to the ref to tell them whether that ball is in or out. So no objectivity needed. You know it's going to be accurate.
100% of the time as Edmund produces a few oohs and ahs with that swing.
That's exactly what that arm brings. She's got power coming right through it, and she's not afraid to take a big rip. If she sees that open, you got to put your hands up quick.
These are high IQ volleyball fans here in Omaha, and that was the biggest reaction they've had to any vibe swing in this match. A little trouble there on the set. Pence with a beautiful pass to Edmund again.
Leah Edmund is just racking up point after point. She's really showing off her range as well. Wherever this ball is, she knows that she can adjust to it to hit the ball, see the defense on the other side, and put that ball right where they aren't.
No question, Edmund has been a leader on this team. Brings a lot of tenacious leadership qualities to Todd Dagenet's group, but he said, we don't just have great leaders, Emily, we have great followers, and that's just as important to a good team.
It's really important when you have a lot of leaders on one team, but you have to have people that are also willing to listen. When you're playing professionally, you know, he talked about all the players on my team, they've been captains at other programs, but it's not only their ability to lead, they also are really good listeners and know when to kind of reel it back a little bit and listen to someone else.
Right now, they're listening to Edmund, who has been the hot hand in this set already. Three kills for Leah since the second set began. Cleveland off the block, but back to Hentz. From the back row, Linehan comes flying in. Hard able to pass it over for De La Cruz. Stringer sets up Fanning, who times that one right.
That ball almost a miss hit from Fanning, but she's good enough to still get on top of it and know exactly what to do with it. Even if it's not the perfect set, if it's in a window for her, Fanning's able to find a way to score.
So after trailing early in the set, Atlanta has tied it up at 8. 26-24, the Vibe captured the opener here in Omaha. Edmund again. Started to take over.
Edmund is absolutely taking over, and it doesn't matter whether she's in the front, now going to the back row. Tori Stringer is going to find her at any time they possibly can, and she lands where it looks like she's actually having that front row attack, but it's just because she's so explosive out of the back row.
Yeah, she's been able to keep the Supernovas off balance, and they're having some trouble with their serve receive at the moment. Edmund's run extends to 3 points on serve.
This is exactly what Edmund wants on that back line, trying to target that seam between the two outsides, between Nunavilla and De La Cruz.
There's Nunavilla missing wide, and the vibes continue to feel good for that group. To our right, Shelton Collier calls a timeout with his Supernovas down a set and 11-8. Jake Kerman, Emily Eamon, back here in Omaha. We mentioned some of the dynamic duos, the college teammates who have now been reunited here in the Pro Volleyball Federation. Some of those have been really impressing us early in this match.
They've been really impressive. On Atlanta's side, we have Leah Edmond and Allie Linehan, who played together at the University of Kentucky. Linehan going on to win a national championship with them in the spring of 2021. Leah Edmond just missing that by 1 year. And then on the other side, you have players like Sydney Hilly and Danielle Hart. For them especially, it's been huge to have those connections down pat, because in this league, they only have a few weeks to train together before they're forced to take the court and play an actual game. So when you're playing next to players that you've either played with at the college level or professionally, it's huge to have those connections develop so early on.
What have you noticed about the way Atlanta has played together here in the second set?
Well, anytime they've been struggling or maybe they lose a point or two in a row, they do a really good job of bouncing back. That passing core is so on lock. When you have Morgan Hentz leading it, there's not a time where that passing core is back there and they don't feel it and look confident trying to side out.
Hentz, also a college champion at Stanford, was the defensive player of the year in Athletes Unlimited. As Cleveland continues to rack up kills, she and Edmond trading punches for Atlanta.
You mentioned what Morgan Hentz did at the college level, you know, picking up three national titles, but really leading this Atlanta team, and sometimes a position that really goes unnoticed. But man, she's one of the best in the entire country, and that's a reason why she's on the national team right now, because she's just that good.
She takes a seat for this rotation. Edmond, more back row brilliance. It's in.
That ball called inbounds again by that Bolt 6 technology. It's an automatic call that goes up to the up ref. Leah Edmond coming out of the back row, really putting that top spin on that ball to land it right in the court. We'll see another look at it.
The Supernovas were not convinced, but as that look shows, the right call was made by Bolt 6 technology. Haven't seen our first challenge yet. The technology will be used on the challenge system as well. Each team has two per set to go with their two timeouts. Watson has been efficient out of the middle, and it's a 5-point lead for Atlanta.
Tori Stringer has done a phenomenal job when she is 5 or 6 feet off the net. Omaha feels like this ball is going outside, but she just uses that little touch to get it to her middles, and that catches the Supernovas off guard.
This crowd can sense the Supernovas needing a lift here. Hilly set her dump, read well by her counterpart in Tori Stringer. Dixon didn't quite make great contact. Linehan blocked, and Dixon makes amends.
Tori Dixon coming up big left and right for the Supernovas team. She knows exactly where to be at what time, and what she does so great is dropping that inside hand to shut down that cross-court seam that she knows the vibe outside's want to hit.
Very few players can read a hitter like Tori Dixon, and she's made all the right decisions here in this second set. That was her second block of the set. No touch there, and Linehan commits an error, which has been rare for her.
And that ball really trying to go for high hands, just missing them a little bit long, but a really smart shot going for that deep corner.
We'll see if De La Cruz's serve can close this gap a little bit for the Supernovas. Shaben Lantzman, popped up by Edmond. Hentz into the scorer's table with the second ball. A dig for Tori Stringer. Cleveland, high hands and a kill.
Right away, you saw Grace Cleveland pointing at Morgan Hentz for not only saving that initial ball, but putting up an insane assist, a beautiful out-of-system set to Cleveland for her to have the ability to put that ball away.
So here's Cleveland serving with a 4-point lead. Block touch from Watson slowed it down as Edmond draws only tape.
Edmond coming in a little bit aggressive on that ball. You could tell she was hitting it on her way down. She's a little bit off balance, forcing that ball to go right in the net. The Supernovas in a really good defensive position to get in there with Brooke Nunneveller coming in to help as well.
Hey, you mentioned the all-around play of Nunneville are even more valuable with the limited substitutions available for these coaches. Hentz read the center dump. Linehan, did it take a touch? It did not.
Head coach Todd Dagenet asking maybe if he should challenge that because it looked a little bit close, maybe off the fingertips, but you could tell. Shaven Lambsman, looks like that ball goes clear over.
If they were to challenge this point, it would come from an iPad, or rather a tablet, being held by an assistant on the bench. They have only 7 seconds, though, to decide after the point is over. And the second kill for the setter, Tori Stringer.
Tori Stringer, such a high volleyball IQ. She knows exactly when to take this dump over, knowing the defense on the other side is not ready to play it up.
Such a leader, too, and that extends even off the court. She's in a dual role, both the setter for Atlanta and a player relations associate working with the league to help make it as great of an experience as possible for its players. What an up by Hentz, but eventually it falls, and the Supernova staying in contact, down two.
Man, Morgan Hentz, three ups right in a row. There is not a ball on the court that she cannot cover. Doesn't go in Atlanta's favor, but man, she is one of the most fun players to watch.
Coach Dagenet calling her a coach on the floor who just knows how to lift her teammates up, get that little bit of extra hustle out of them.
She's one of those players that's just easy to play for. Everyone loves her. There's not anyone that doesn't love watching her as well.
Watson again, getting a touch. Edmund that time with block number two.
A beautiful set from Natalia Valentin Anderson, pushing that back set all the way, but Leah Edmund read it beautifully, getting all the way out, head up on that ball to turn that left hand down and shut her down.
We talked about the all-league team selections coming into this match and the impact that they would have. Just three kills in the early going for Betty De La Cruz. Leah Edmund up to six. As De La Cruz on cue, make that Nia Reed coming off the bench, the former Penn State star.
And a beautiful set and an even better swing from Nia Reed on the outside, using a lot of power, seeing where that block was, and going right inside the defenders in the backcourt.
And Coach Collier leaning on her experience too. We saw her film in the Brazilian League, where she was named the best opposite, the best scorer, and said that's who we need on this team. That one tipped over by De La Cruz. Edmund dug out of the back row by Nunneviller. Another setter dump causing trouble, but a great get by Nunneviller. Almost fell in. Edmund sent back again by Reed. A third swing, a third block. That one jousted for by Fanning. What a rally.
Natalia Valentin Anderson using that experience to her advantage. She pushed that ball to the back corner knowing there was nobody in sight to play it.
That's a 13th year pro and an Olympic team captain, also the all-time assist leader at Florida International. The native of Puerto Rico who moved back to Omaha 4 years ago. Her husband is from Omaha. She had retired, but when the Supernovas came to town, it felt like fate that she would join the team and pick up her pro career.
And Natalia Valentin Anderson is such a good leader for this team, a good emotional, inspirational leader that every player loves to play with and play for.
Here she sets up Hart, who can't quite find the spot. Edmund connects again.
Leah Edmund having a field day up front. She knows exactly where to take this ball. She's mixing up her shots really well, though, not hitting the same shot over and over again, this time going right over the block to the back corner. That's the best shot that you can have as an outside hitter.
So far, Atlanta doing what Coach Dagenet set out for them to do, take the crowd out of the game, control their side of the net. They've passed the ball extremely well, thanks to Hentz, who sets up Cleveland there. White to Reed, the Penn State connection, working there for the Supernovas.
And again, the Supernovas find themselves down late in the set. They have a lot of work to do to try to get back to it. It all starts in the service line, though, trying to put in enough pressure to knock Atlanta out of system.
It hasn't been an easy task, but they've started to do it a little bit more. As the former Cornhusker, Mancuso Przosowski, serves for the second time. That one didn't have enough. The vibe back up by three.
And as you're trying to come back late in sets, it's so important to keep the ball in play and play as clean as possible. The other team isn't going to give you free points. You have to earn every single one.
Coach Collier's team looking for a late run here in the second. After Atlanta took the first, 26-24. Edmund flying in from the back row. What a set she's had.
And you'll hear oohs from the crowd all night long on those balls. And you see a big smile from Leah Edmund's face. She brings so much power, even from the back row. She gets on top of it so fast and brings that swing through.
Too much for even the great passer in Valentina Anderson there. Nia Reed took that swing. Fanning blocked by Dixon.
What a read from Tori Dixon up front, stepping right in front of the hitter's line of approach, getting those hands over as far as she possibly can to shut down Fanning.
Boy, where would Omaha be in this set without Tori Dixon? She's got three blocks.
Tori Dixon has been massive up front. It's not just those stuff blocks. She's also getting a lot of touches that allows her backcourt to transition those into good offense.
Fanning on the quick hitter. That's been an effective play all night for the Vibe.
Much smarter decision for Shelly Fanning up front. She got blocked on the one before. This time had to take a much sharper angle to it and turn that right thumb down to hit it sharp back to left back.
Both middles for the Vibe. Fanning and Watson have been very efficient in this match. Fanning on serve now with Watson in the front. And that one's popped up by Stringer. Playing the carom nicely was Hilly. Dixon helped it over. Linehan, pancake by Hilly. Big point here for Omaha. Two saving plays on defense. Can they transition into offense? Shaben Landsman, side outs.
Shaben Landsman bringing the heat on such a long rally. Oftentimes, we'll see hitters take a little bit off as rallies go longer and longer. Not Shaben Landsman. She's ready to just unload on this ball and finish it off.
The former Iowa State indoor player, LSU beach player, was in the coaching world. Sort of been out of her playing days. Was coaching in town here at Blair High School. Called the coaches, asked them if she could try out. And the rest is history. She's impressed everybody here at Omaha, and she's helped the Supernovas back into this set. This inaugural Pro Volleyball Federation match. We've seen a couple of carbon copies so far on the scoreboard. The Vibe get out to a lead. The Supernovas battle back, and their student section, every college student that got in for free, is hoping they can tie up this match.
Yeah, it's not often you see student sections at professional games, but that's exactly what you get when you play a volleyball match in Nebraska.
And they have been waiting for a chance to erupt. Tori Dixon brings the Supernovas back to within one.
And all of a sudden, Betty De La Cruz during work from the back line, getting an ace to force the timeout, and then right away, again, forcing that overpass.
What can the two-time Olympian deliver here? That one dug up by Kendall White. Block tooled by Nunaviller, covered by Stringer. And Cleveland finds a cross-court kill.
Grace Cleveland's been a little quieter during this set. We saw her be explosive during set one, but now late in sets, Tori Stringer knows that she can trust her in these big moments.
Atlanta 2 points from a two-set lead here in the opening PVF match. Not yet.
Well, Brooke Nunaviller came up clutch during set one to bring the Supernovas within one during that set and push it into extras. And they know they can trust her in these big moments when they're down a few points to get right back at it.
Can the team ranked preseason favorites to win it all produce some magic? And they are right now.
Omaha doing work from the service line. First it was Betty De La Cruz, and now Tori Dixon, the middle blocker in the back row, doing work, forcing over passes. Atlanta looks really uncomfortable in their passing core.
Timeout called by the Vibe. This is the first time, Emily, in this match that they've really looked uncomfortable in serve-receive, and it's Omaha that stepped it up a notch from back there.
Yeah, it looks like right now that Atlanta's had some question marks at serve-receive just in the last few points where we've seen them be so solid this entire night. Morgan Hens has led them so, so well. And in this rotation, it looks like Lee Edmonds struggling just a little bit in those seams to call it off early and get a good pass.
Well, this crowd that's been waiting to make their mark on this match is involved now. Nebraska, known for their record-setting volleyball crowds, maybe some sweet treats along the way can certainly help the cause. But for these fans, it's been a long time coming to see these players performing on a stage like this.
It's so exciting for, you know, everyone in the sport of volleyball, whether you play or coach or just a fan of the sport, to have now a professional league in this high level of play that you can just drive to and watch rather than fly 6-7 hours to potentially catch a match.
And in this venue that's hosted numerous Final Fours, in this state that's hosted record-breaking crowds, not just for volleyball, but for women's sporting events worldwide. You think about the Volleyball Day at Memorial Stadium last August. What a place for this new league to start. And Watson sets up a set point.
Tori Stringer using a very effective, efficient middle blocker in that rotation. Really smart to go to their middle right then.
Set point for a 2-0 lead. Linehan on serve. Hence to Edmund. Set saved there by Kendall White. Edmund again. Blocked again. Popped up for Watson. Hilly to Nunaviller. Linehan was there. Edmund. Was it touched? It was. And the Atlanta Vibe take a 2-set lead here at the CHI Health Center. Now, Shelton Collier has his tablet in hand. They might take a look at this. Might as well challenge from his perspective.
Yeah, upon first look at that, it did look like it was clear out of bounds. It didn't look like Shaven Landsman had touched that ball. I think even Leah Edmond thought she hadn't touched that ball initially based on her reaction when she came down from that swing. But as we take a few more looks at it, it looks like that ball is clear to the right side of Shaven Landsman.
So what a big first decision for the Pro Volleyball Federation Challenge referee. This adjudication will happen in Frisco, and they'll get to use the Bolt 6 technology to help them out.
You can tell how good the cameras are here. Oh, net touch.
I see. So rather than the shot being tipped, they're going to say Shaben Landsman was in the net. And this will likely confirm the two-set lead for Atlanta. It has.
Yeah, important to note that even if you do challenge whether or not that ball was touched, the refs are still able to look at that net and see if anyone was in it, and that precedent sets over whatever was challenged as well, if there's any fault happening at the end of the play.
So that confirms the 25-23 second set. This match has been razor tight, but Atlanta able to grab a two-set advantage. We'll switch sides after this.
Supernovas fans, it's time for a little bit of what we call Volleyball Musical Chairs. I'm sure I can think of a better name than that, but I've got six contestants out here. They're going to use the two-foot boundary line with volleyballs on the inside. They have to run inside, grab the volleyballs, and make it back out. And the last one out with the volleyball is out of the game. Let's meet our contestants. Just go ahead and wave when I say your name. We've got Gabby. Everyone say hi to Gabby. We've got Lily. Everyone, give a big old hello to Eileen. We've got Evie. We've got Coraline. And the wonderful Kinley. Everyone say hello to our friends. Ladies, are you ready to play this game? The balls are behind you. We have our DJ Popo ready. When the music stops, you run. We go around in circles in 3, 2, 1. DJ Popo, yeah. Grab the ball. Last one back to the line is out. Oh my gosh, that was rough. Who's the last one out? Fans, can you help me out here? Right here? All right, you're out, man. I'm so sorry. Give a round of applause for playing. Let's do that again. We're going to do this plenty of times. We're going to get it down. Go ahead and walk around the circle, friends. Can you steal the ball? Everybody give a big old round of applause to Coraline.
the inaugural game of the Pro Volleyball Federation delivering so far here from Omaha. The two teams ranked 1 and 2 in the preseason poll, playing a pair of hotly contested sets in front of what we anticipate as a potentially record-breaking crowd for professional volleyball in the United States.
It's been so exciting, and this is exactly what we want. We've seen close set after close set, the first one going into extra points. Second one, Omaha coming storming back, but Atlanta again just winning it by 2 points to go up 2-0. But the level of play that we're seeing tonight is so elite, both offensively and defensively. They're putting on a show for some of these fans that were so excited to come.
And for young fans to be able to have role models, right, in their hometowns to say, yes, I can play professional volleyball and I can do it right here at home.
It's never been a thing that young players can see growing up to aspire to do. A lot of times you don't even know the option of playing professionally until you're in college and someone tells you that you might be able to play at the international level. But now they can see these players that they followed in college to do it here in the States. It creates a platform that is unmatched.
As the teams prepare for set three, if you joined us late, let's catch up on some of the high-flying action from that last couple of sets. Omaha able to make late surges. Tori Dixon has been a presence in the middle.
Tori Dixon has been massive. She's already racked up 4 stuff blocks just throughout 2 sets alone. Omaha doing a really great job defensively getting touches, but it's really been that Atlanta offense that is just firing on all cylinders. A lot of that coming from Leah Edmond, who has already racked up 12 kills through just 2 sets, averaging 6 kills a set, unheard of numbers. Those are the kind of numbers that you're going to see night to night from a player like Leah Edmond, bringing so much power, a lot of strength from that shoulder, and Tori Stringer is going to find her every chance she can.
Yeah, what's impressed you about Tori Stringer's performance tonight? The 2-time ACC Setter of the Year looks very comfortable in this atmosphere.
Well, Stringer's doing a really good job. Of course, we're seeing Edmond rack up a lot of those kill numbers, but Stringer actually is setting a pretty balanced match. She's getting those middles involved as much as she can, especially out in service heap, getting them involved 5, 6, 7 feet off the net to continue to really test Omaha's defense. But I really like what she's doing with the tempo that she's setting to the outside. It looks like the connection between Leah Edmond and Stringer is really top-notch right now.
During this break between the sets, let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first 2 sets, or rather the statistics here on our report. You notice the kills nearly doubling, sometimes tripling, the errors and the blocks at even 6 apiece.
Yeah, both teams playing decently clean. You'd like to see that efficiency not listed there, but go up for both teams. 12 errors for Atlanta and then 14 for Omaha. But it's really those kill numbers for Atlanta and that efficient offense really going to work with Stringer at the helm, setting a beautiful match, getting everybody involved, and then those pins really able to put it down quickly.
At this break between sets, what do you think this gives an opportunity for Coach Shelton Collier and his staff to tell these players?
Well, I think the biggest message that he should be telling his players is right out of the gates, we have to come prepared. We saw Atlanta take massive strides early on in set 1 and set 2 to get a really comfortable lead. And then we saw Omaha turn it on. They had to storm back to even play catch up. They've been playing catch up this entire night. What they need to do now is start off strong, get a few points under the belt before they feel comfortable. And it starts right at the beginning, and they have to do a better job serving and in service to really control the pace right away.
Yeah, the serve receive for Atlanta has certainly been on point, and their all-league libero certainly has something to do with it. Morgan Hentz and the Vibe have been able to weather a couple of storms late in sets to build this lead, and they have a chance for a straight set victory here on the road in Omaha. The Supernovas will surely have something to say about it here as set number 3 gets set to commence. Tori Dixon up in the front row with Hart playing middle back. That combination, who've been able to work together, sort of emblematic of the Supernovas MO as a team. Coach Collier said he knows at the professional level, you're not going to change who these players are, but you are going to change your system to let them fit in. And, well, the vibes are good over there for Atlanta.
And it's so early on in the season. Of course, it's opening day. Teams are still trying to work out the kinks, figure out their starting lineup, and really shore up those connections. What we've seen on both sides, the connections look pretty good, but it's just implementing them consistently has been a struggle.
Fanning starts off the third set just as she did in the opener with an early kill right out of the middle.
Right away, Tori Stringer able to find her middles and establish them as a threat early on. What that does is it opens up seams for the outsides when she goes to them later in the set.
Her efficiency in this match, a big part of the reason the Vibe have this lead, and so is that. Leah Edmond.
And Todd Dagenet talked to us about how important and crucial the back row attack is at this level, and he knows that he has to make that a staple of their offense. And Leah Edmond, when she's in that backcourt, she is a threat.
Dixon answers right back on the slide.
Tori Dixon right now, the Omaha's point leader, now racking up 9 on the night between what she's doing defensively, blocking, and offensively, making sure that she's involved.
So now the dangerous serve of De La Cruz, getting accustomed to life here in Omaha. She has traveled the world in her accomplished volleyball career. Couple of aces already for her in this match. Nunna Viller pop back up by Hentz. Brooke again, high hands again, slowed down by Cleveland. Linehan finds a low angle. White, beautiful pass to Nunna Viller, who can't connect.
Nunna Viller a little bit frustrated with herself after that play. She knew that she might want that one back. That ball set up so high, the timing just a little bit off to send it in the net.
Have you noticed a lot of frustration coming from the Supernovas side of the net? Obviously, this match not going the way they planned, but they've only lost 6 less points than Atlanta.
Well, I think this team's still trying to figure out their identity and really what works, especially offensively in their systems as they put that ball down. But look, they've only had a few weeks to train together, and you know, you have new faces and new players. Yes, they might have experience, but it takes time to develop those connections, especially between the setter and all the hitters.
What's the hardest part? What's the last step in making that connection, even for a professional?
Well, I think it just takes a lot of reps, and a lot of that's in the practice gym. You want to have as many hitting lines as possible just to get those connections down. But it's a whole different ballgame when you're actually stepping on the court, playing a match. You have to talk about it a lot quicker.
Again, just the first of a 24-match schedule for both of these teams over the next 4 months. 7 teams a part of the inaugural Pro Volleyball Federation. Columbus and Grand Rapids are up next tomorrow with a 7 p.m. Eastern time first serve overpass right to Linehan.
Really smart decision from Allie Linehan to go up with 2 hands and shove that one down rather than taking a swing on it. Because this ball is so tight, it's a risk going up and taking a swing because she might be in the net. That was a lot safer bet and still put the ball down.
And she just beat Shaben Lansman to the spot. Atlanta again off to a strong start in a set. Hart quickly side outs to tie it at 4.
And an easy put down for Danielle Hart, working so hard to get up on that one and send that one straight down, cross her body, finishing her right arm back to that zone 1 in the right back.
She's met the moment here tonight. One of 4 rookies on this Supernova roster. De La Cruz offhands a powerful swing from behind the 10-foot line.
Omaha needs a little bit more of that. They have to use their back row a little bit more often. When you have a weapon like Betty De La Cruz back there, you got to get her going.
De La Cruz has sort of warmed up as sets have progressed in this match. She's been good late in each of the sets. Maybe try to get it to her early here. Nunna Viller off the high hands of Stringer. She sets Edmond. Popped up by De La Cruz. Hart took a touch from Edmond, and Watson is there.
Kyrus Watson felt like she hung up there for about 5 minutes. That hang time just floating in the air before she's able to put this ball down. But a great heads-up play, getting up and taking a hard swing.
Reminiscent of her brother Benjamin out there on the gridiron, the former Georgia Bulldog, NFL star. The strength of Karis's game is her variety. Coach Dagenet raved about her ability to swing to anywhere from anywhere.
It's so important as a middle to not just be one-dimensional and not just hit quick sets in front. They move her along the net, whether it's on a gap or on that slide. She has the ability to run every bit of that offense.
How can the Supernovas use this crowd here to turn this third set. They lead it by one, looking for two with De La Cruz. She jousts it back over, setting up an Edmund swing. Great up by White. The former Penn State Nittany Lion saving that point. And a block. Hart and De La Cruz. That's how to get the crowd in it.
That's exactly how to get the crowd in it. Nothing gets your team or crowd more hype than a massive stuck block. This is exactly what the Supernovas needed. They need this crowd on their side. The best way to do that is getting up and putting it right down.
Boy, their middles have been outstanding in this match under the direction of assistant coach Bird Kuhn, who played for Shelton Collier at Georgia Tech in Atlanta. That was Coach Collier's first call when he got the Supernovas job. He said he wouldn't have taken the job without Bird, who you see closest to him on the bench. The associate head coach and one of his former players. Edmund slowed down by the presence of Hilly, who dumps one over and down. And the first extended run for the Supernovas early in a set tonight.
All of a sudden, Omaha's got some momentum headed into this one, forcing the Atlanta timeout, trying to make a storm here in set one, up 9-5.
Supernovas hoping to bring some of that college-like atmosphere into the Pro Volleyball Federation. There's the student section. Any student ID gets you in free on that end of the court, and they're making the most noise out of anyone right now.
I think Omaha knows how well and how well attended some of these matches are at the college level, whether it's Creighton or with the Huskers over in Lincoln. They pack that place.
Well, right now, it's a rare occasion where fan bases of, say, the Cornhuskers and the Blue Jays can all agree and cheer.
That's what sports does. You know, it brings people together. Even, you know, student sections and schools that have these massive rivalries, this is the perfect time to bring them together.
Saw Nebraska's Hall of Fame coach John Cook address the fans on the video board before this match started. And Hart with another thunderous swing.
Impressive up from Morgan Hentz, but it was not enough from the power that Danielle Hart's bringing up front. Massive heads-up play goes up right away. Smart snap down.
Seven of the last 8 points have belonged to Omaha as the serve trickles over to Stringer. Shaben Landsman to the rescue there. And a whistle here. Four hits whistled against Omaha. One of the first violations we've seen called besides the net at the end of the second set.
Not exactly sure what the ref saw there, an extra touch somewhere maybe off of a player. I think Shelton Collier wanting a little bit clarification on what exactly happened. But four hits touch, so maybe brushed off the shoulder of someone. And that counts.
If it was a block touch versus no touch, that's something that Omaha could have challenged. Coach Dagenet on the other sideline was upset there because Coach Collier didn't challenge in time and he felt like his server got iced. The 15-second serve clock has given this match some quick tempo as Paige Briggs, the rookie from Western Kentucky, checks in on serve.
And it's difficult to come in as a serving sub. You have one job, you know, get the ball in play, try to knock the other team out of system. It creates kind of a pressure vacuum when you're back there of, okay, I have to hit this serve really well. And sometimes you'll see those serving subs come in and miss.
Briggs was the fifth overall pick in the American College Player Draft as Hilly wins a joust. Shaben Lansman punches it back over. Cleveland, cross court.
Huge swing from Grace Cleveland on the right side, going up and over the blockers for Omaha, going right to that back corner, splitting that right back and middle back defender beautifully.
Yeah, it's been tough to get around Tori Dixon at the net here tonight. That swing did so there as De La Cruz gets blocked. She's wondering if it landed out of bounds. The point for now awarded to Atlanta.
Grace Cleveland coming up defensively this time. Beautiful setup, getting that right hand on the ball to shut down De La Cruz.
Atlanta's block, bringing them back into this set, but Dixon with a quick side out.
And all of a sudden, once Omaha gets a little bit of momentum, that's when you feel this crowd really coming into play, getting loud, so excited for some of these big plays, and that's exactly what a strong middle attack will do.
Hilly racks up another assist. Cleveland with great shape there.
Really smart shot from Grace Cleveland. Just a light touch right over the block, identifying that Omaha's libero is pretty far back on that ball. So the light touch over leaves a lot of space for her to cover.
Atlanta showing great poise here on the road in front of tens of thousands of Supernova fans here in Omaha. So far, Atlanta has spoiled the party. De La Cruz looking to change that. Linehan offhands. Hilly finds Nunaviller. Denied again. Watson forming the block.
Atlanta forming an absolute wall up front, getting all three blockers up on this back row attack. Really smart schematic blocking from the vibe, getting all three up.
The team picks second in the preseason poll. All of a sudden, right back in this set, they were down six a few moments ago. Can cut it to one on this point. Dixon has other ideas, sent back by Watson again. And De La Cruz able to cut through the block that time.
And everyone trying to hype up this Omaha squad. You see Kendall White right in that huddle, trying to get a big smile on Betty De La Cruz's face after a really smart kill, hitting it high and flat right at the fingertips.
We asked Kendall White about the number one preseason ranking next to the Supernovas' name. She said they have to embrace that target on their back. She said it was going to be there anyway, given where they are, what their roster looks like. They've got to take that and run with it. No touch there, and a point back to Omaha makes it 15-11.
Not only does this Omaha team have a target on their back, but they also have maybe higher expectations than some of the other teams in this league, just because they are in a volleyball hub of America. These fans expect greatness from this team.
The Vibe have decided to challenge that last play. Evidently, they thought there was a Supernova touch. And the first in the career of Todd Dagenet. Dagenet awaits the Bolt 6 review. And he's like the rest of us right now, waiting for Frisco.
Just waiting for that call to come back to the up ref, Stephanie McClarty. Question of whether or not there was a block touch off of this swing. Initially ruled just out of bounds. We'll see if any finger bent back. Usually these calls are pretty quick. That ball going right through the hands, no block touch.
And so the fans and the stadium DJ get their wish. The officials decide to let it be in Frisco. And Omaha's back up by four.
I mean, just a beautiful camera angle on that. It feels like those of us that are used to the college game, man, that speeds it up. That's good stuff.
One of 22 high-definition cameras that will be at every Pro Volleyball Federation match to decide on those coaches' challenges. So one challenge left for Coach Dagenet, and Dixon continues to dominate.
Atlanta having trouble controlling that pass, whether it's in serve receive or defensively, just getting really tight on some of these passes. Omaha is doing a phenomenal job controlling the net up front.
So much best of five experience for these Omaha players. They have come out with a little extra pep in their step to start this third set, knowing the mountain that there is to climb. And they're finding different ways to score now.
Shaven Landsman, impressive shot, going zone two, back to zone two. So sharp, but cutting it right inside. Those are the kind of shots that you practice time and time again.
The Vibe call timeout. This second set tilting in the Supernovas' favor. The inaugural match of the Pro Volleyball Federation here in Omaha could be trending towards a fourth set. The Supernovas on yet another run during De La Cruz's serve, but it's been a team effort here to help turn this match around in set three.
Omaha playing much more clean on Atlanta's side. They're not playing clean. They're making errors that we haven't seen them make all match. The connections don't look as good as they did during set one and set two, and the passing has really lacked.
That one took a touch off the block, and so Atlanta gets the side out. Coach Collier looking back to his staff, and they've decided to challenge this play. We get another chance to look at bolt six and their review. Again, each team with two of these per set, and if you win the challenge, you get to keep it. Coach Dagenet lost his challenge earlier in the set. He has one remaining. Coach Collier using one of his first two here and having a chance to catch up with Natalia Valentin Anderson, his setter from Puerto Rico. What do you think this conversation could entail?
Well, it seems like Omaha is definitely struggling from an offensive standpoint, but he's pulling his setter, who is not currently in the game, but maybe telling her he wants her to go in and make some changes or something to watch for, so Natalia Valentin Anderson can tell Sydney Hilly something maybe in a timeout.
Now let's see if bolt six shows us a block touch on Tori Dixon. There you have it. No touch, point Supernovas, a successful challenge for Coach Collier. That's the first of its kind in league history. Add that to the 41-year resume. His teams, especially over a 22-year run at Wingate, never quit. He helped take that Division II program in North Carolina to 18 NCAA tournaments in 22 years. As you take a look at the attendance tonight, 11,642 here at the CHI Health Center. A new record, Emily, for women's professional volleyball in the U.S.
And so exciting to think back to that Olympic qualifier in 2016 in Lincoln, where they had just over 10,000. But now the league opener here for Pro Volleyball Federation already shattering that record.
Tori Dixon on serve. She played in that Olympic qualifier. She was also there at Volleyball Day in Lincoln. So where she goes, the crowds seem to follow, and she can't quite catch up to that smart shot.
No, Atlanta down in this set. They have to try to make a comeback now. That really starts on the service line. Allie Linehan has to put in enough pressure to try to knock Omaha out of system, because they have so much momentum right now here in set three.
Linehan, the Indiana native who was a national champion at Kentucky, does exactly what you thought. Serving up an ace. It's not always that 70-mile-an-hour bomb off of her arm, but it's usually pretty darn accurate.
Well, what made this so good was it was right in between the seams. It doesn't have to be that hard, but if you make those passers talk about it, it can become difficult.
Her range has impressed Atlanta in minicamp as Hart draws a touch there off the block and out.
Danielle Hart doing a really good job taking this swing back to the right back, or whether it goes off the block, but she's swinging through the ball, finishing her right arm to her left side, forcing it out of bounds.
Valentine Anderson comes in to serve. We mentioned her journey as the Puerto Rican national team captain. She's an emotional leader who knows how to get the best out of her teammates in each and every practice. De La Cruz ready for that Edmund swing, and the block tooled by Nunaviller.
And Omaha just storming away here in this third set. They took that lead early on, and they have run with it. Everything clicking for the Supernovas.
Valentine Anderson with designs on ending the set here from the service line. Can't do it there. The Supernovas still 3 points away, though. The first two sets decided by 2 points each, 26-24 Atlanta in the first. They took the second 25-23. They were able to withstand late Supernova runs to win the big points late. Can they put a little pressure on Omaha here to close out this third set? Not a given yet.
And right out of the gates, Yapo coming in as a serving sub, doing her exact job, forcing Omaha out of system and picking up the ace.
The former BYU and Arizona star with nearly 2,000 career digs. There's a sub making an impact, Gina Mancuso-Prozoski.
And this crowd loves her. From Omaha, played at the University of Nebraska, and anytime she checks in the game, you're gonna hear this crowd roar.
A member of the Omaha Sports Hall of Fame, that's how much of an ambassador she's been for this great volleyball city. One of the first players who they signed, and it's not just about being from Nebraska. She's earned the respect of everybody in that locker room, according to her head coach. Set point, and a whole bunch of them.
Betty De La Cruz reading that so well, stepping right in front of Tori Stringer and shutting it down.
Over 11,000 strong in this record-setting crowd on their feet for the set. Not yet. Tori Stringer there to keep the set alive for the vibe.
And Atlanta trying to just gain some momentum as we probably head to that set four. Kind of a long way for them to go here in this set, but they need to string together a few points.
Stringer serving into the net. And the Supernovas have extended this match by winning set three, 25-17. Well, the Pro Volleyball Federation is underway, and it's revving up now to full speed. A busy slate of action over the next 16 weeks with a total of 84 matches culminating in the championship in May. Grand Rapids, who is the first franchise formed in this league, they get to host Columbus tomorrow night at 7 p.m. Eastern.
I'm so excited for all of these teams to really get going. It's been such a long time coming, and now we're finally having opening day. Tomorrow we get another match. But to see so many of these stars back on U.S. home soil playing, where we haven't seen them in so long for some of them, maybe even a decade for some of them, back on the U.S. soil playing, whether you're watching on TV or you get to go live in person, it's been so fun.
Here's an updated look at some of the match stats. The aces have been hard to come by, but yet the kills creeping up.
And Omaha is doing a really good job, especially in that last set during set three, getting their offense finally going. They shut down Atlanta's offense that was roaring during those first two sets. They played better defense, and they find ways to put ball down on the other side.
And a quiet set overall for Leah Edmond, who had 14 kills in the first couple of sets. She'll start on serve in the fourth. De La Cruz, another strong swing. She's starting to find her way into this match more and more. It hasn't just been the offense today for Bethania. White with another dazzling dig, poked over by Nunavilla. Linehan, dug out again. Shaben Lantzman from the back row. Dixon read well by Cleveland. Linehan, dug out by White again. Both liberos trading great digs. Hentz takes her turn. Those are the rallies that we come to the PVF to see. That was touched by Atlanta. And we'll see if we get a challenge here. We will get to see this one again.
Right out of the gates, you can tell just how important both teams think every single point is in this match. We've seen really tight sets, especially those first two sets, but now we've seen long rallies and challenging right away to make sure that no point goes unnoticed.
So they gave Omaha this point, ruling no touch on the play. But the vibe are challenging, saying that Sydney Hilly, the setter from Wisconsin, might have gotten a piece of that one near the right pin. Here's what Bolt 6 has to say.
Yeah, that little finger bent back.
And a successful challenge, as you can see outlined in green. And Todd Dagenet will keep both of his for the rest of this set. De La Cruz ready at the left pin.
De La Cruz, even off the net, just finds difficult ways to score. This ball so far off, she looks off balance, taking it well behind her head. She still finds a way to barrel it through the block and use some power.
Starting to feel right at home here in Omaha, as a punishing kill comes right back the other way for Linehan.
Allie Linehan wanted that point over as quick as possible, barreling that right inside the blockers.
That one let the air out of the balloon from this sellout crowd, or rather record crowd.
Yeah, Atlanta wants to silence this crowd as much as possible because they definitely got involved during that third set.
Supernovas used a couple of extended runs in that third set to claim the momentum. Two separate stretches in that set saw them win a stretch of 7 out of 8 points. The first of those two runs came on De La Cruz's serve. Linehan denied again. Dixon and Shaben Lantzman.
All night long, Tori Dixon has been up there helping to form a wall for the Supernovas. They're doing such a great job identifying where these sets are going and moving explosively and fast to get outside and up.
That blocking is coordinated by John Shea, the longtime USA volleyball assistant coach. As a tough angle there, great reaction, Nunaviller, as Shaben Lantzman shapes it inside the pin. Linehan able to terminate.
Linehan using power to go right through that block. Shaben Lantzman tried to play that up with her elbow, a little chicken wing action, but couldn't get that up. Linehan just swinging too hard.
Here's Grace Cleveland again. Hilly picks out Nunaviller.
Nunaviller just so explosive right away. When she sees that set go up, she's up in the air and ready to just explode on this ball, getting on top of it and swinging down.
She was the only player in the history of the now extinct Pac-12, at least on the volleyball side of things, to record 1,500 kills and 2,000 digs. It speaks to her all-around talent.
And Brooke Nunaviller is just a generational talent. We saw what she could do in her first few years at Oregon as a libero, an insane libero at 5'10". And then moving to the outside, she was just as good offensively, able to put a ball down. And it's not just her play, man. She just plays with such joy. She's so much fun to watch.
So is Hart, who's brought great energy for the Supernovas.
And Danielle Hart, coming off of a few years ago, tearing that ACL, missing her senior season, coming back at the University of Wisconsin, winning that national championship, and now at the professional level, just dominating, trying to make that Olympic roster.
We talked about Coach Shea and his work with this Supernova block. He'll be with the Olympic team in Paris this summer, as so many of these players vie for spots with that group.
But it also gives the Olympic coaches in Karai an ability to watch these players a little bit easier than, you know, waking up at 3 a.m. and trying to watch some of his prospects and people on the women's national team play. Now he can just turn on his TV and watch them right there.
More trouble on serve receive for Atlanta. And you saw that upcoming schedule. There are so many chances to watch professional volleyball all over the country now. Soon San Diego, Vegas, Orlando will join the mix. All seven teams will be in action as an ace from Shaben Landsman makes it 8-4 Supernovas here at set four.
And it is difficult to ace a player like Morgan Hentz, one of the most consistent passers in the entire league. But Shaben Landsman just bringing a lot of heat right in the seam.
Atlanta feeling that heat and the pressure of an Omaha run. Timeout called by Coach Dagenet. He's got the t-shirt to prove it. Match number one and plenty of super fans here at the home of the Supernovas, the CHI Health Center.
It feels like these fans have a new energy now that the Supernovas are really looking like they're playing their game. They took that set three pretty handily and have a pretty good lead by four here in set four.
Well, if these fans didn't love the Supernovas already, they will now thanks to the fight this team has shown. Lost two competitive sets to open up this match, but they've since responded by going on a 22-11 run dating back to the middle of set four. They have dominated the last 10 minutes or so. Atlanta with a good timeout to get right back in this set, though.
It was really interesting talking to Coach Shelton Collier about the fans, and he knows, obviously, they love volleyball, and they're so smart and knowledgeable on the sport. But it's also interesting when you have a new league starting up and so much fan support. He was interested to see whether or not the fans were coming to see the team, or are those fans coming to help them win and really get behind them?
Well, in the first couple of sets, it was the oohs and the ahs of the efficient offense for Atlanta. They were clicking on all cylinders, but now this partisan crowd has started to really get behind their team, their newfound team.
It's definitely easy to get behind a team when they look like they're absolutely rolling, which is what's happened during that last set in here in set four.
Nunnabiller has been a big part of it. Trouble there at the net. Nice job by Hart to adapt after a hit off the tape. Fanning blocked. Another one for Danny Hart.
Danielle Hart getting her team pumped up, taking control of the net, reading this play so well, staying disciplined in her movements, not moving until she knew exactly where this ball was going.
Coming to this team recruited in part by Sydney Hilly, who is her setter, a year older at Wisconsin. One of those dynamic duos who have had collegiate success, hoping that translates here in this new Professional Volleyball Federation.
Leah Edmond putting that ball down, and Atlanta has to find a way to continue to get those numbers as they were during set one and set two. Not rely on her too much, but just put Leah Edmond in better situations so she can put a ball down.
The Supernovas have adjusted well to Edmond to force what you're talking about. So much familiarity, both from the collegiate and professional days between these players. Coach Dagenet said, yes, we would stress scouting reports, but these players already know each other's strengths so well.
Yeah, so many of these players have either played with each other or played against each other for so many years, it feels like they already have scouting reports, whether or not they're playing on the other side.
Serve hit the tape. Hart forces it back on one from Stringer. Slide play. Danielle Hart just missed it.
Smart swing from Danielle Hart, trying to go right down that line. The shot that she was given, just sending it a little bit long outside Leah Edmond.
So the Supernovas called timeout. Atlanta has come back from an early deficit. They now trail by just 1 point in set four. A fun night at the CHI thus far. The Supernovas entered this set with a lot of momentum, built an 8-4 advantage. Atlanta looking to tie it on this swing. Hilly over on two after a tight first ball. That one missed, no touch. And a big side out ends a run of 3 points for Atlanta.
The Supernovas playing really scrappy volleyball. Any ball you might think is down, maybe it's close in the tape, they manage to get out of the tape, send over to Atlanta's side. That puts a lot of pressure on the Vibe just to keep that ball in play.
So now Paige Briggs, the five-time all-conference player, selected fifth by Orlando in the inaugural PVF draft. Omaha was very upset when the Valkyries made that selection, so much so that they traded to get Briggs on their team. Her good serve was returned well by Atlanta there.
Paige Briggs was a player that Shelton Collier said he actually wanted from the beginning, was so excited when she hit that portal. They really wanted to trade for her.
One of only a handful of those rookies from the draft to make the 14-player roster, as these teams had to narrow it down to 14 ahead of their first match. De La Cruz paints the corner pocket. with Dixon drawing the block the other way.
It doesn't get much more beautiful than that. Betty De La Cruz taking a risky shot going right at the corner, but that's what you get with 22 years of experience.
Here's another look at it. Right on the line. Linehan, she's been precise as well.
Linehan does such a good job mixing up her shots. It's not just all power. A lot of times she'll throw in shots that really test those blockers out, shots that she's not looking at but is still able to hit.
This was about the point in the third set where Omaha made their run and sort of found their footing. Can they do something similar here to force a deciding fifth set? Out of system there for Shaven Landsman, but it works. A rare mistake from Atlanta.
More of a miscommunication on Atlanta's side. The ball dropping right between two players. A good shot from Shaven Landsman, but more of a miscommunication from Atlanta. No one talking about where that ball is and who's going to play it up.
Lots of advice given after that point by Brian Doyon and Sally Polhamis on that Atlanta bench. The assistants for Coach Todd Dagenet. Both bringing in a combined 32 years of collegiate experience. Sally actually spent some time on Shelton Collier's staff at Georgia Tech. The fans watching back in Atlanta hoping that their new team can beat their old coach here on the road.
And this ball, net call on Atlanta. Just getting a little bit aggressive up front.
Supernova lead back to three. That serve stung, but Linehan able to pass it well. Here comes White with a running bump set for Shaven Landsman. Linehan sent back by the former Cyclone. Cleveland takes her turn and guides that one across to the corner.
Big shot from Grace Cleveland on the right side, going right to that seam between middle back and left back. Such a good shot. If it's open for, she's able to attack.
Vibe will bring in Marley Montserrat on serve. The former Florida Gator, an all-SEC selection, who played some beach volleyball with UCLA, another rookie, getting her first chance to serve. She goes right to De La Cruz. Shaven Landsman gets blocked. Another big play from Linehan and Watson. It's been a great rotation for Atlanta.
And a huge read from Allie Linehan up front. Her hands weren't in the right position to start, but she moved them right back into the seam, taking it away.
Boy, the star players have delivered here on night one of this Pro Volleyball Federation. Dixon, another one of those, who's been a key option for the Supernovas. One of their three Olympians on the roster. 35 Olympians in total in the league. Short serve, read well by Hentz. Here's Linehan taking a sharp angle for Nunaviller. She swings through a double block, and that courageous choice pays off.
That's a play that Tori Stringer might want to ask for help on. It's coming so quick off of that pass. She doesn't have time to get there in time and put up a good set. That's a play where she might want to yell for help and have Allie Linehan step in to set that ball.
Stringer on a slide for Watson. Great up by De La Cruz. Still a chance, though. Edmund. Pancake by Hilly. But the second ball, not to be.
A lot of 50-50 balls at the net, whether they're coming down on top or right into it. Both sides doing a pretty good job controlling that play. This one just so difficult for Danielle Hart to track and turn around and get up in time.
How about the angle there from Sydney Hilly?
Hey, good pancake up.
Here Hilly takes the second ball, setting Hart, but she didn't have a lot of options there. Difficult first ball to deal with.
A perfect read from Karis Watson up front. One-on-one solo stuff of Danielle Hart getting in the perfect spot, not taking that hesitation step, but staying put and going up strong.
I know Jason Derulo as a part owner of the Supernovas. Watson riding solo on that block.
Knew that was coming.
Atlanta didn't know that was coming, though. Nunneviller has been dynamite over the last couple of sets. She's up to 14 kills.
Especially late in sets, this is when Nunneviller really turns it on. She has that competitive drive to want the ball and ask for it in these big situations, and she's not afraid to take a massive rip, even in front of a huge block in front of her.
Her fearless swing puts Nati Valentin back on the serving spot. That was a good one, but it's not down yet. Hart can put it away, though.
And a huge play from Danielle Hart, just on Omaha taking complete control of the net.
Two blocks, seven kills in this match for Hart. Similar serve. Stringer's there, and so is Edmund. First time we've heard from her in a while.
And Edmund's not afraid to continue to take big rips, even though she's not getting set as often as she was during set one and set two. When she does have the chance to take a big one, she's going to take it.
And you saw the block there of Mancuso Prososki just a little bit late. Edmund able to take advantage on that left pin. And here's Casey Evans, the Georgia Bulldog. Nunneviller able to read that one well off the first touch as White loops it over. Edmund again.
Edmund starting to come alive, and Tori Stringer knows late in sets she's the person that she has to get the ball to. Edmund has that drive in her to know that late in sets she's going to continue to take big swing after big swing in these big moments.
This has been a back and forth set. Atlanta's won four out of the last 5 points to draw back within one. Hart, another strong swing, assisted by Valentin Anderson.
Such a smart set from Valentin Anderson, getting that middle going on a ball that wasn't exactly perfect. It's about 10 feet off the net, and she still trusts Danielle Hart to continue that route in.
She's been a trustworthy option out of the middle. As the Nunneviller serve has arrived with a 2-point lead for Omaha, looking to force a fifth set, which would be first to 15. Should we need it? Can Omaha stay alive on their home floor here in this league debut? That one sails wide of the antenna, as signaled by Devaney McLarty, our first referee. And the Supernovas up by three again.
And Atlanta definitely not happy with that call, and it looks like they're looking to challenge it again. They only have 7 seconds to do so. You could see the assistant coach reaching for that iPad, but it doesn't look like they did it in time.
Tori Stringer was talking to the referee, trying to buy some time. Remember, Coach Dagenet was successful on his first challenge of the set, so he still has both of them in his back pocket. White picks out Prozoski, but the block was there.
We talk so much about what Leah Edmund can do on the offensive side of the ball, but she is a massive force up front defensively. She reads the game so well and knows where to get those hands, and she can get them so far over the net.
The vertical of Leah Edmund on display. Once again. Vibe back to within two. Here's Stringer. Another quick hitter for Hart. Back over and out.
Danielle Hart has been clutch in these big moments. She knows exactly when to turn her game on. This will send her back to the service line, where she's done well defensively in the backcourt too, but man, she's getting on top of those balls.
Before that, Coach Dagenet calls timeout. His vibe down by three here in set number four. We've talked about Leah Edmond. What can a young player at home learn from watching her performance tonight?
Well, what you can learn is what it takes to be a good outside at this level. And it's not just your offensive ability. It's really your all-around game. You have to be able to pass. That's something that Leah Edmond does so well. Defensively up front, you got to be a big blocker. She also does that well. And then, of course, offensively, she's a big-time scorer and can hit all shots in the book.
Approaching the 20-kill mark here in this match. Leah Edmond leading all hitters at the moment. Free ball sails wide, and Omaha closing in on set number four. What's the biggest change you've seen over these last few minutes?
Well, Omaha just completely looks in control. It looks like Atlanta has a few things to figure out. You're not seeing as tight of huddles. Of course, they're not getting as excited about points. Meanwhile, Omaha on the other side, they looked as gelled as they have.
That error brings the Supernovas within two.
Back-to-back errors now for Atlanta, not characteristic of this team that normally plays really clean. And now we'll see a substitution with Reagan Pittman, the former middle blocker for Minnesota, come in. But, man, their coaches loved what she's been doing on the right side.
How about what Hart's done? In a lot of ways, this has been her set. She's controlled it from the middle and now from the service line.
And she's been huge in her all-around game. We saw her during, I think it was set two back there. They didn't win that set, but, man, she was putting up multiple digs during single rallies alone.
Once again, late in a set, Omaha making their run. Atlanta deciding whether they were going to challenge anything on that last play. As we await Hart's clearance for serve. Grand Rapids hosting Columbus tomorrow. 7 p.m. Eastern time, first serve. You know, those two teams are watching tonight and can't wait to get in on the quality and the atmosphere that we've seen.
I think there's so much excitement, of course, for opening night, but really for all these teams that are starting their seasons. Just so excited to finally get the ball rolling. They've been a part of the league for so long, some of these players, just ready to get going.
Now, I didn't see the official make a challenge signal. And now, the first referee has called over Tori Stringer to give a quick explanation. Not sure whether this pertains to the serve clock or perhaps something with the new technology that Atlanta and the first referee are looking to get on the same page about. It gives Omaha some time to think about the way they've been able to build this lead in set number four. We've got to see some of their mixture of established veterans, hungry younger players. And Shelton Collier, who you see now talking to his team, a lot different demeanor than he had in the first two sets. All smiles down there from the 41-year veteran who spent lots of time in Atlanta coaching Georgia Tech. What an up by Nunavilla. She's covered every part of the court on this point as De La Cruz steers it just inside the antenna. Edmond again, not quite able to dig that one.
And after two insane ups from Nunavilla in the back row, she's just frustrated with herself. She couldn't get that third, but man, a beautiful swing from Leah Edmond sends its ball way to the back corner. That's a really difficult ball to even get a touch on.
Able to cover so much ground in that point, and yet Atlanta still able to stay in system. Still have a shot here to wrap this up in four. Omaha can make it more difficult here. Hence with a great up. Dixon the second swing.
There's no stopping Tori Dixon. When you leave her none on one with that open net, she will put it down 10 times out of 10.
Five chances for the Supernovas to take this inaugural Professional Volleyball Federation match the distance. Hilly serves it up. Linehan, blocked by Dixon. The Supernovas have fought back from two sets down, and the CHI Health Center is on its feet.
Insane comeback from the Omaha Supernovas to rally back down 0-2 in this game and push a fifth.
Our decider is next. Jake Herman, Emily Eamon on hand here in Omaha. Could we have asked for a better first match? This crowd has been treated to four exciting sets, and the fifth to 15 will decide.
And Omaha Supernovas coming roaring back after being down 0-2. This is exactly what we wanted on opening night between the top two teams in the league going head-to-head. You maybe thought the Supernovas were down after being down 0-2. Atlanta Vibe really coming up clutch. But then Omaha comes storming back, taking control of sets three and four.
These fans, Emily, did not sit down during the entire set break. They are ready to make an impact here. And a quick start, always important in a first to 15.
The start is so important because this set goes so much quicker than those first four. It only goes to 15. It feels like the weight of every point is almost 2 or 3 points. And this is when you see the big plays happen, especially from the defensive end. You will see both of these teams going absolutely all out for every point.
A night that so many of these players and coaches had circled on their calendars, really, for months and months on end. And a lot of them said it's going to take a few sets to settle in. The reality is not going to set in until we feel that atmosphere in person. Everybody present in the moment now.
And so exciting for all of these players who, of course, play on opening night. But to get that fifth set in opening night, it really feels like the start of a league that's going to be so exciting. And with the atmosphere that we have, even more exciting.
Now, we talked to Omaha about being ranked number one, Atlanta about being ranked number two. They said it doesn't matter. We know the talent that's out there around the league, and they expect night in, night out to play matches like this. So far, those coaches have been right on the money in their predictions. But who will grab the first win in league history? Cleveland able to race off court to grab that one. Hilly sets Dixon.
And Dixon, the player to watch for Omaha during this fifth set. She's been huge defensively, and as this match has gone on, getting more and more involved in that offense.
Four blocks in the match for Dixon, who helped wrap up that fourth set for the Supernovas. She was one of their few consistent options offensively early in this match. and they found some other players who have really stepped up, including Nunneviller, who was big in that fourth.
Brooke Nunneviller has been huge, and really on both sides of the ball. We saw some jaw-dropping defensive plays, and she's been getting it done on offense as well.
How about Jess Shaben-Landsman, coaching high school volleyball just months ago, had been out of the game, and now she finds herself in the center of one of the best matches here on U.S. soil.
And Omaha's offense getting a little bit more dynamic, running cross patterns with their middles on that slide and the right side coming in on a two ball.
De La Cruz already with multiple four-point runs on serve. That makes that swing even more important. It just missed, nearly a side out for Atlanta.
And watch for Tori Stringer to go right back to Leah Edmond off of that miss to give Edmond some more confidence headed into this fifth set.
You talked about the way Stringer has sort of felt the pulse of this match, involved several different hitters. That was what Atlanta felt like would be their strength. Incredible up by Hentz, and that sets up Edmond. Heck of a point there by the Vibe.
Keep your eye on Leah Edmond. She's going to get a lot of sets in this fifth set. Tori Stringer knows that in these big moments, Edmond is the player she wants to get the ball to because she's so clutch.
Certainly made her mark early in this match. Already up over 20 kills now. Hilly, beautiful set for Nunneviller.
Nunneviller coming up clutch for herself on the Omaha side, just flying through the air, going up and over those blockers. So difficult to do, especially for an attacker that only stands at 5'10". But man, she can jump through the gym going over them.
How about Hilly and her passing tonight? So calculated and so smart out there on the floor. Edmond off Nunneviller's block touch, and Dixon couldn't pop it up.
And in that huddle, Sydney Hilly trying to tell the team, hey, we got to forget about that play. Let's get this side out right away because you can't let Atlanta go on a run.
Hilly a part of that dynamic duo at setter for the Supernovas. She gets this second ball, a quick hitter for Hart.
Danielle Hart came up so big during that fourth set to really push Omaha into this fifth set. We'll see if she can continue to do it, and she has to stay involved offensively in order for the Omaha Supernovas to get a win.
Hilly and Hart, when they moved to Omaha, talked about how relieved they were that these fans will be on their side now. They're used to coming to Nebraska and feeling this crowd on top of them, cheering their every mistake. Now, they're feeling the wind in their sails from the Supernova fans in Omaha. Lenahan, too strong. The block touch carried it long.
Really smart shot for Allie Lenahan, going up and over the blockers, but hitting those fingertips to send this ball well out of bounds.
So a big couple of points there for Atlanta after they trailed early on in this 1-15 deciding set. Kamiley Hiapo, the libero from Arizona, comes in on serve. Back set for Nunneviller. Popped up Cleveland. White to Valentin. De La Cruz flies into the picture, but so did Watson.
And that's a play that Omaha has to make. That ball is skyrocketed after that block right back to the middle of the court. You'll see so many players around this ball, but no one calls it off to make a play on it.
You saw the miscommunication there between White and Valentin Anderson. Still getting used to playing on the same page. Tied at 5. That point awarded to Atlanta after Linehan was able to tool the block. Boy, how did she do that?
Yeah, really smart shot from Linehan, identifying a stifling block in front of her, but she swiped it right off the fingertips out of bounds. Such a high IQ play.
No challenge from Shelton Collier. 6 apiece.
And every missed serve just really takes the wind right out of the sails for either team. This is when, in a fifth set, you have to play as clean as possible. When it's tied, you can't make those errors.
The two teams ranked first and second in the preseason coaches poll, separated by just one vote in that poll. That's how close this match has been. Separated by 1 point now in the fifth set.
That's exactly what you'd expect from the top two teams that are absolutely packed with stars on both sides.
Cleveland, who got off to a really strong start in this match, the opposite for Atlanta on serve. Hentz able to read De La Cruz. Linehan. Right back to Nunneviller. De La Cruz strikes again.
Huge swing from Betty De La Cruz right down the line. A beautiful set from Valentin Anderson. Pushes this ball all the way out to the pin. She's able to get on top of it and just identify the blocker's hands a little bit too wide, going right through stringer.
How quick has that right arm been tonight, even at age 36?
Oh, it's been massive. The snap down that she has is some of the quickest in the world.
A reason that her free agent signing made such big waves around the league. Here's Paige Briggs, the rookie. Side out, Edmund tools the block. That's rare. Atlanta's had trouble dealing with Dixon tonight.
Yeah, Dixon's been an absolute wall up front, especially against a player like Leah Edmund. She's getting a lot of touches. This time, Edmund gets the better of him, identifying where that block was, turning that right thumb down to put it inside.
First real momentum that Atlanta has had since winning that second set. Too strong from Betty De La Cruz, and the vibe within 6 points of capturing this decider.
And this is when both sides have to play as clean as possible. Don't take those risky swings. Just keep that ball in play, but continue to play with power.
Shelton Collier calls a timeout. His Supernovas have come back in this match, but have to do it again here in set five. The student section on the edge of their seats. Emily, you've talked all night about how this match is as close, as exciting as you expected. Has anything surprised you from what you've seen through 4.5 sets?
No real surprises. The stars are being absolute stars. The defense has looked incredible, and this is exactly what I expected with this tight of a contest.
And it gets even tighter. Block number 5 for Tori Dixon.
Tori Dixon just owning the net up front. Every time she's up there, it feels like Atlanta panics just a little bit, trying to get around her, thinking a little bit too much because she formed such a big wall.
So here's Hilly, whose pinpoint passing has helped the Supernovas win the last couple of sets. If you joined us late, Atlanta took the first two sets in this inaugural Pro Volleyball Federation match. And they're back in front by 2, thanks to Edmund. Well up over 20 kills now.
And as this set gets later and later, look for Stringer to continue to get Edmund the ball as often as possible. No one else might even get set because they know they have to get Leah Edmund the ball in these big moments.
De La Cruz, yes.
Easily handled from Omaha, incredible pass. Gets a fast tempo set outside to De La Cruz, which makes a hole in that block, and she's able to just barrel right through it. Pass to attack, that's what Betty De La Cruz does best.
No chance there for Casey Evans to pop that one up. Shaben Lantzman tools the block. Tied at 10.
A huge time for the right side to come up clutch. A beautiful out-of-system ball. She's able to just go right inside of them.
The Iowa native made this roster over some of the rookies who they may be expected to take starring roles. De La Cruz showing up as well in this fifth set as Atlanta takes a timeout. It's a race to five now in the inaugural Pro Volleyball Federation match. No quit in this Supernovas team, who fell behind after losing two competitive sets to start this match. They've since overcome a two-point deficit to tie this decider at 10. Nunaviller, smart shot, and the Supernovas lead.
Such a smart decision from Nunaviller, who's known for bringing that power. She rarely throws in these off speeds. That makes this the perfect time to do it when the defense is expecting that powerful attack.
Three in a row on De La Cruz's serve, and now four.
All of a sudden, Betty De La Cruz gets this Omaha team roaring back. There is no quit in them. They've been down 0-2. They've now coming running back down in this fifth set, but they found a way to string together point after point.
Here's another look at the ace.
Man, Betty De La Cruz's serve is so difficult. It's not just a topspin, but it has a little bit more side spin to it as well. You might think you know exactly where that ball is going, but it ends up one step to your left, and that forces Leah Edmond to try to make that last second of adjustment on this pass, and she can't get it done and wrap those arms around.
Boy, how many players and how many fans in how many different countries have gotten to see that serve over the course of her 22-year career? Now, it's here in the U.S. with the new league.
Oh, man, it's been so fun to watch, especially for a player who's had 22 years of experience, played in what feels like every single country playing professionally. Now to see that in the United States on this kind of stage, it's been so fun to watch.
We asked her, how are you staying warm in the Nebraska weather? She said, oh, believe me, I've played in much colder temperatures when she was playing in Russia in the last decade. Making a lot of new fans here at Omaha tonight, but knowing these fans, they're already so familiar with her game, giving her some of the love she deserves as the official calls a do over here. The music had it concluded, and De La Cruz will have to serve it again.
It's a pretty good serve, though. Getting just a little bit of rhythm. It's loud in here, hey. Maybe.
Now, if you're De La Cruz, do you change up your plan here?
Now, I think you go with what you've been doing. Again, attack Leah Edmond on this ball who just made the error.
Edmond right now in the back left for Atlanta. It goes her way, and it aces again.
Betty De La Cruz knew the assignment. When you have two outsides passing right next to each other, the perfect seam to hit is right between them, and she pinpoints it right there.
A unanimous member of the preseason all-league team. Showing you why right here and right now in winning time on opening night. That ends her run of six consecutive points. But Omaha just 2 points away from a comeback victory.
And huge for Betty De La Cruz to string together that many serves in a row that were tough, knocking Atlanta out of system. The vibe, they've got work to do to come back.
That'll cut the deficit in half. A block from Shelly Fanning, teaming up with Cleveland.
Fanning, who's been a little bit quieter defensively, coming up really big in a massive moment, getting all the way out. Feet aren't quite there, but she reaches that right and left hand back into the seam to close it up and get the stuff.
With De La Cruz having been the hot hand, but now sitting in the back row, what's Omaha's plan here on serve receive?
Well, Omaha knows that with her back there, they also have to have her as that offensive weapon in the backcourt. So maybe they don't have the perfect pass. They can still use De La Cruz from the back row. But hey, when you have Brooke Nunneveller up there, I would say in this moment, when you're only up 1 point in the fifth set, 2 points away from winning it, give the ball to Nunneveller.
This Atlanta team, which snuck away with the first two sets, surviving late supernova surges, had a lead early here in the decider. Now trying to play catch up after the run of six on Bethania De La Cruz's serve. They got the side out. They got one of those 2 points back. It's up to Tori Stringer and her big serve to try and tie this decider and avoid a match point. Dixon, nearly into the campfire. Cleveland offhand, saved by Shaman Landsman. Great up by Stringer. And a rare error in the middle. 13 all.
And man, it doesn't get much tighter than this. In these big moments, that's when you can't have these errors. You have to play as high level volleyball, as clean as possible.
It was always going to come down to this point, wasn't it? 13 all in the fifth. That one sailed wide. The block touch came from Tori Dixon, and it's match point for Atlanta.
Big swing from Leah Edmond tooling the block. Such a smart shot, not using all of that power, but just going for the outside hand to tool it out of bounds.
Boy, it came ever so close to hitting Leah Edmond's leg on the way back down, but she was able to steer clear, and Stringer serving match point for the Atlanta Vibe. Hence to Edmond, who ends it. The Atlanta Vibe win the first match in Pro Volleyball Federation history.
What a comeback from the Vibe. They go up during that fifth set. Started this match up 2-0, but there is no quit in any of these players, or really either of these teams. Omaha coming back down from 0-2 to force a fifth, but Atlanta never gave up, even though they got really tested during set three and set four.
They were down 13-10 in the deciding set, and then Tori Stringer able to serve it out with some big-time help from her outside, Leah Edmond.
That's exactly what you want from these players. Leah Edmond, a player that we knew we had to watch coming in this, who made that preseason all-league team, a high-level volleyball player that did so well during those first two sets. 12 kills during just those sets alone. Got a little bit quieter, but man, she really picked up her game in the fifth to lead Atlanta to the win.
So while this record-setting crowd will go home upset, they certainly can't be upset about the quality, the level, the atmosphere they saw here tonight. We'll recap it all on the other side of this break. Wow. for one final time courtside with Emily Eman. I'm Jake Herman. What a night we just witnessed. A five-set thriller. The Atlanta Vibe, down 13-10 in the decider, are able to escape the CHI Health Center with the first win in league history. What a moment for that franchise, but really everybody involved here tonight.
And this is exactly what we thought we would get with two of the best teams in the league. On opening night, we knew it was going to be competitive when we have star power on both sides. I'm not sure we knew that we were going to get that close of a match, but man, the stars showed out and these fans showed out, and they got a really good match tonight to open things up.
These fans never gave up. The Supernovas showed great fight after losing the first two sets in heartbreaking fashion. Just a combined 4 points separating the teams in those first two sets, and they were able to turn it up a notch to force the decider.
It was so important for that team, that for Omaha, to, even though they went down, to continue to fight back. You know, they have so much fight in that team. They got their passing together. Setting-wise, they were making much better decisions. They got the middles involved just a little bit more, and those stars really showed out.
Well, if this was an appetizer for the four-month season that is yet to come, then there is a lot of great volleyball still left to be played over the course of that journey. Tomorrow night, Grand Rapids gets their turn, as do the Columbus Fury, the Rise and the Fury, with first serve at 7 p.m. Eastern time. Wow. What else can we say about this night and what it meant for the sport, for these athletes, for these fans? It checked all the boxes.
So exciting to have this kind of stage for these athletes and to have so many fans, of course, watching at home, but over 11,000 packed into this arena to watch professional volleyball in the United States, to watch these stars that they saw at the college level, maybe haven't seen for a few years, saw them compete tonight in really high-level volleyball played.
Let's take a look at the final stats from tonight's match. The kills outnumbering the errors. Omaha a little bit better in receive and on serve, but the Atlanta block made a big difference.
Atlanta's block came up really big, especially at the end. They were able to shut down Omaha, and really from the service line, they only had two aces, but what they did really well was knock Omaha out of system, win it mattered in those really tight sets at the end of set one, end of set two, and then, of course, at the end of set five.
I'll leave us with this. Atlanta Vibe owner Colleen Craig talked about how she wanted to change not just the story for professional volleyball, but the storyteller. And these athletes certainly told a compelling story tonight. We look forward to seeing the stories that they'll tell throughout the season.
So excited to watch these athletes continue to compete at and compete at this high level, continue to push this sport forward, especially in the United States, where it's absolutely exploding.
On a history-making night for professional volleyball, the Atlanta Vibe win an inaugural match in five sets in front of a record crowd here in Omaha. On behalf of all the men and women in our technical crew under the direction of Brent Borkus, I'm Jake Herman. She's Emily Eman, saying so long. We'll see you tomorrow night in Grand Rapids for more Pro Volleyball Federation action.